boats are, well, you know that I'm around, 'cause I'm a wanderer.
Changes. In the year 1945, my great-great-grandfather, serving in the army, wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen. He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The world awaited Armageddon. Instead, something miraculous happened. We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction. Domestic robots, fusion-powered cars, portable computers. But then, in the 21st century, people awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource. The entire world unraveled. Peace became a distant memory. It is now the year 2077. We stand on the brink of total war. And I am afraid. For myself. For my wife. For my infant son. Because if my time in the army taught me one thing, it's that war never changes. Never changes.
You're gonna knock him dead at the Veterans Hall tonight, hon.
You think?
Absolutely. Now get ready and stop hogging the mirror.
Right. Hey, hon.
I'll just be a minute. Why don't you see if breakfast is ready?
Ah, good morning, sir. Your coffee. 173.5 degrees Fahrenheit. Brewed to perfection. And today's newspaper just delivered.
Thanks, Kazuha.
Of course, sir.
Grognak the Barbarian and the Jungle of the Bat Babies. My favorite. Sugar bombs. 100% daily value of sugar. Nuka-Cola. Ice cold. Looks like the milk got delivered.
Oh, sounds like someone...
Saddle up Salisbury steak. Grade A plus.
You know, I was nervous at first, but Codsworth's really good with Sean.
Hmm. More of the same.
...coming down from Canada, making it crisp and dry for next week's Halloween. opening festivities.
Hun?
We should take Codsworth to be serviced soon, don't you think? Well, look at you. How'd a girl like me ever get so lucky, huh? Can't believe it's almost Halloween. Oh, need to finish making Sean's costume.
I'm so proud of her.
Can you get that?
Good old USA.
It's probably that salesman. He comes for you every day.
Good morning! Vault-Tec calling.
Vault-Tec? Remind me again?
Why, we're about you, sir. And helping secure your future. You see, Vault-Tec is the foremost builder of state-of-the-art underground fallout shelters. Vaults, if you will. Luxury accommodations where you can wait out the horrors of nuclear devastation. You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
What's so important?
Why, nothing less than your entire future. If you haven't noticed, sir, this country has gone to heck in a handbasket. If you'll excuse my language, the big kaboom is... It's inevitable, I'm afraid. And coming sooner than you may think, if you catch my meaning. Now, I know you're a busy fellow, so I won't take up much of your time. Time being a precious commodity. I'm here today to tell you that because of your family service to our country, you have been pre-selected for entrance into the local vault. Vault 111.
But there's room for my entire family, right?
Of course, of course. Minus your robot, naturally. In fact, you're already cleared for entrance. It's just a matter of verifying some information. Don't want there to be any holdups in the unforeseen event of total atomic annihilation. Won't take but a moment.
Sure, let's do it.
Splendid! Splendid. Now, let's see. Wonderful. That's everything. Just gonna walk this over to the vault. Congratulations on being prepared for the future.
Thanks again.
Hey, it's peace of mind. That's worth a little paperwork, right?
For you and Sean, no price is too high.
Good answer.
I have my moments.
Sean has been changed, but he absolutely refuses to calm down. I think he needs some of that paternal affection you seem to be so good at.
You heard Codsworth. Go on.
Hun.
I'll be there in a minute. Go ahead. How are the two most important men in my life doing? Spin the mobile a bit. He loves that. Hey, how's my little guy? Much better now, huh? Listen, after breakfast, I was thinking we could head to the park for a bit. Weather should hold up.
Will it be like that night in the park a year ago?
Sir? Mom? You should come and see this!
Codsworth? What's wrong?
Hey, hon?
What's wrong with Codsworth?
Followed by... Yes, followed by flashes, blinding flashes. Sounds of explosions.
Codsworth.
Sir, trying listen. To get confirmation.
What?
We seem to have lost contact with our affiliate stations. We do have coming in. That's, confirmed reports. I repeat, confirmed reports of nuclear detonations in New York and Pennsylvania. My God.
Oh, my God.
We need to get to the vault. Now!
I've got Sean. Let's go.
Residents of Sanctuary Hills, if you are registered, evacuate to Vault 111 immediately.
Vault participants, this way!
Shh. Shh, it's okay.
Who cares?
Just help me pack it up!
Residents of Sanctuary Hills.
All Vault participants, check in at the gate!
That's absurd! I am
not on the
Vault
list.
Tech.
You don't get in.
I'm going in. You can't stop me!
No.
Okay. I'm reporting this!
If you're in the program, step forward. Otherwise, return home!
We need to get in. We're on the list.
Infant? Adult male? Adult female?
Okay, go ahead.
Thank you.
Good luck,
you
man.
You two, follow me. God, come on.
What's going to happen to all those people outside
the gate?
We're
doing everything we can. Now keep moving.
Step on
this
the
way.
Platform in the center.
Almost there. We're gonna be okay. I love you. Both of you.
We love you too.
Oh my god!
No, no! Send him down now!
Hold on!
Can't this thing move faster?
Oh god! We did it. We made it.
Hun?
Everyone, please step off the elevator and proceed up the stairs in an orderly fashion.
No need to worry, folks.
It's gonna be okay, right?
We'll get everyone situated in your new home. Vault 111.
This is our new home.
A better future underground.
So we just...
This is our new
home. Yes, up the stairs.
I can't believe it. If we left a minute later...
No.
We'd all
Don't get caught up thinking about that. You're safe now.
All new residents, please proceed.
Male.
This way.
Welcome.
Female and
this one's good.
Step over to the table. Take a suit. This
You'll
way,
need
please.
Your suit.
Okay.
Welcome.
We can take you further.
Pick up a suit right over there.
Thanks. What now?
Just follow the doctor
Just this
here.
Way.
He'll show you where to go.
All right, you three. Follow me.
See? This is our new home.
Oh, you're gonna love it here. This is one of our most advanced
right,
facilities.
Good.
Not that the
right
others aren't
there.
Great, mind you.
Good. Over
it's
there.
It's gone.
Take a suit.
Our home. Everything we
Sir?
Had.
My mother
here
and father
are.
Down in
D.C.
Oh, God, honey.
How long do you think
it?
We'll be down here?
I know this is a difficult
Oh, we'll be
time.
Going over all but that in orientation. Just a few medical items we have
just
to get through first.
The list
it's designed
as they come
to be fashionable
in.
As well as comfortable.
Prepared for the future, right?
Such a lovely family you have. I hope you'll see this as your new home.
Just step in here and put your vault suit on.
Shh. It'll be okay. Daddy's right here. See? Honey, could you help me?
Who's my little guy? I'm not going far. I'll just be over there.
There he is. See? Daddy's not going far.
All set? Just step inside and put on your vault suit.
Hun?
Go ahead, hun. I'll take Sean with me.
The pod will decontaminate and depressurize you before we head deeper in the vault. Just relax.
Time for a whole new life.
Resident secure. Occupant vitals normal. Procedure complete. In.
Biogenic
basis suspended.
This is the one. Here.
Open it.
Has to be a release! Come on, come on, come on! Oh, God!
She's alive. Giant roaches? What the hell? Yes. Gotta find the terminal. What happened here? Where is everyone?
sequence initiated. Please, stand back.
Here for work? We could use some help picking melons if you've got some spare time. I'll give you caps for any you can bring me.
Did you say caps? Why would I want those?
Yeah, like bottle caps? And because it's money? At least it is here in the Commonwealth.
You guys pay for things with bottle caps? What happened to dollars and cents?
That old stuff? Not too useful these days, unless you're looking to stock up your outhouse.
What are you paying?
3 caps per melon. Not a bad deal, if you ask me.
You look like you have a pretty successful farm here.
We'd like to think so. Having Clarabelle helps. Free fertilizer, as Daddy would say. Whatever saves caps.
Clarabelle? Who's that?
Claire is our Brahmin. I like to consider her just as much a part of the family as Maisie. She's our cat, in case you were going to ask about her, too.
And what's a Brahmin?
Did my daddy put you up to this? That big two-headed animal in the pen with patchy fur? That's a Brahmin. That's our Clara.
Maybe I'll help out later.
That's all right. If you ever do feel like earning some extra caps, the offer's always there.
That's close enough, stranger. We're a peaceful farm. We don't want any trouble.
You have anything to trade?
You looking to trade, you can talk to my wife. She's up by the house. But be warned, you try anything, you're asking for a fight. Let me tell you, farming ain't easy. Out in the field all day, every day. And every minute of it, spent watching your back.
What kind of crops do you grow here?
Mostly potatoes so far. But we're starting on melons. Blake Abernathy. You new to the Commonwealth?
Yes. And no. It's a long story.
Either way, good to see a new face. How about you? Ever think about working the land?
Don't know. Never really thought about it.
Hell, neither did I. I was born into it. Word of advice, though. If you do start up a farm, be ready to deal with the raiders. Why do all the hard work when you can just take what you want at gunpoint?
Raiders. The name alone says something.
You really are new. The name's only the tip of the iceberg. They're well-armed, take what they want, and kill whoever gets in their way. Last time those raiders hit us, my daughter Mary tried to stand up to them. Now she's buried out back of the house. Only 21 years old, and they shot her down without a thought. That's why we need the Minutemen back. And the sooner, the better.
What happened to the Minutemen?
Don't rightly know. I suppose they just went on to other things. The Raiders are certainly making the most of the opportunity. I don't have much to offer, but those Raiders that killed Mary, they took her locket, too. It's been in Connie's family for generations. If you could get it back, it'd mean a lot to us.
I'll see what I can do.
Good. Connie feels like it's a part of Mary. I don't think she'll rest easy again as long as it's gone.
Hi.
Oh my God. It's really you. This can't be happening. This isn't happening. What happened to the world?
My son is missing. Our son.
I don't know. He's gone. God damn it. Someone took him. They stole my baby.
How long have you been here?
I'm not sure. I'm just doing what it takes these days.
Is anyone alive? Did anyone get out?
Everyone's dead.
All that matters is that you survived. We've survived this far. We'll make it to the end.
You're right. I'm sorry. At least you and I made it through this.
What do you think we should do?
I don't know what to do. Ugh. The world's changed so much. None of this makes sense. I just want my son back. It's hopeless. I've lost him. Sean's gone.
Don't worry. I'll get him back.
I'll find who did this. And I'll get Sean back. I promise.
Thank you. Thanks for sharing that with me. Family's important.
Don't worry. I haven't lost faith in you. You can travel with me. See the world. Or what's left of it.
Do you really mean that? Thank you. That's kind of you. Let's stick together.
I was in cryogenic storage for a long time. I only just woke up. How did you manage to escape?
I was about to ask you the same thing. I got shot up pretty bad. So I found a stim pack. Found a couple of them, actually. I only thawed out recently. The bastard who shot me. Took my baby. I don't even have a clue who he is or where he's gone. Either way, I need to find Sean. Hey, hun. Thank you. We're in this world for the long haul. Together. Let's get out of here.
Hey, hun.
You ready to head out?
You sure you want to travel with me?
You know, you're a very refreshing person to travel with.
New here? Well, if you've got anything worth trading, you can talk to me.
What have you got?
It ain't a lot, but I've got a few basic supplies. Ammo, meds, that sort of thing.
Ammo and meds? What kind of basic supplies are those?
Very basic. You want to survive out here? You need ammo and meds. So, you up for a trade or not?
You'd think on a farm you'd have produce, not ammo and meds.
The potatoes and melons are for the larger trade up in Diamond City, not to mention our own table. So, still interested?
What's a tato? Short for potato.
Let's just say it's the mighty, rad-resistant cousin of the tomato and potato. Potatoes, mute fruit, taberries. Things change to survive nuclear fallout. Get used to it.
How is the trade with Diamond City?
Good. When my husband actually gets around to doing it. That is, if no one raids the farm first. Why do you think I'm selling ammo and meds? You can't protect yourself? The Commonwealth will swallow you right up.
Can't say I've been to Diamond City yet.
Biggest city in the Commonwealth. Anything you need, anything you want to know, that's the place to start.
All right. Hey, boy. What are you doing out here all by yourself? You want to come with me, pal? Okay, then. Let's stick together.
Oh, that's the face I fell in love with.
Get no spending cash. If you don't scrap that kitchen floor, you ain't gonna rock and roll no more. Yakety yak.
Still kicking? Jesus!
Wait, I knew it.
Hey, up here! On the balcony! I've got a group of settlers inside. The raiders are almost through the door. Grab that laser musket and help us, please!
Good idea. Wouldn't want these things falling into the wrong hands.
This is gonna be
gone!
No!
No more prisoners on your papers!
Telling you, man, let's just get the hell out of here. We got no reason to hang around and get shot.
Stop being such a fucking pansy. We hold out for the others, like we're supposed to.
What are you, deaf? Somebody's out there shooting the place.
Time to reel it in.
Make a team.
Skin every last one of you!
Come on, man. They ain't going nowhere. We got other shit to deal with.
You hear that? I gotta go take a little walk.
Come on. In here!
Man, I don't know who you are, but your timing's impeccable. Preston Garvey, Commonwealth Minuteman.
Minuteman?
That ain't it.
So now I'm traveling backward in time?
Minuteman. Jesus.
Protect the people at a minute's notice. That was the idea. So I joined up, maybe. Wanted to make a difference. And I did, but...
nope.
Things fell apart.
Now it looks like I'm the last Minuteman left standing.
Who are these people?
God damn it.
Just folks looking for a new home. A fresh start. I've been with them since Quincy. Lexington looked good for a while, but the ghouls drove us out of there. A month ago, there were 20 of us. Yesterday, there were 8. Now we're 5. It's just me, the Longs, Marcy and June. That's old Mama Murphy on the couch. And this here is Sturgis.
Ugh, I'm calling it right here. This world can officially bite my ass.
No problem. I'd be glad to help. Hun?
Hey.
Ghouls? What are ghouls?
God
damn
it.
You really aren't from around here, are you? Ghouls are irradiated people. Most are just like you and me. They look pretty messed up and
nope.
Live for a long time, but they're still just people. The ones I'm talking about are different. The radiations rotted their brains, made them feral. They'll rip you apart just as soon as look at you. Anyway, we figured Concord would be a safe place to settle. Those raiders proved us wrong. But, well, we do have one idea.
One good idea can make all the difference.
Sturgis, tell him.
There's a crashed vertebrate up on the roof. Old school, pre-war. You might have seen it. Well, looks like one of its passengers left behind a seriously sweet goodie. We're talking a full suit of Cherry T-45 power armor. Military issue.
I like it.
Yeah, I thought you might. Protection with an added bonus. Get the suit. You can rip the minigun right off the vertibird. Do that, and those raiders get an express ticket to hell. You dig?
Minigun. Now we're talking.
I know, right? Only there's one hitch. The suit's out of juice. Probably been dry for 100 years. It can be powered up again. But we're a bit stuck.
I'll help if I can.
What you'll need is an old pre-war FC. A standardized fusion core. Your high-grade, long-term nuclear battery used by the military and some companies way back when. And we know right where to find one.
But we can't get to the damn thing. It's down in the basement, locked behind a security gate. Look, I fix stuff. I tinker. Bypassing security ain't exactly my forte. You could give it a shot.
Actually, I already grabbed the fusion core. We're set.
Don't worry. I'll help you deal with these raiders. Let's do this.
Well, all right. Maybe our luck's finally turning around. Once you jack the core into the power armor and grab that minigun, those raiders will know they picked the wrong fight. Good luck.
Now look who dog meat brought to us.
So, he's your dog?
He ain't my dog. No, sir. Dog meat, he's what you call his own man. You can't own a free spirit like that. But he chooses his friends and sticks with them. He'll stay by you now. I saw it.
Great. You're completely nuts.
From where you're standing, I would seem crazy. My gift is pretty nuts, that's for sure. But it's the chems, kid. They give me the sight.
What's the sight?
I can see a bit of what was and what will be. And even what is right now. And right now, I can see this something coming. Drawn by the noise and the chaos. And it is angry.
What is it? Mama Murphy, I need more, please.
I see. I see. Oh. It's horrible, kid. Claws and teeth and horns. The very face of death itself. That's all I can manage. That's all. I need to rest now. And you have a job to do.
No.
Hey.
There are more of you. Right? These are our lives you're playing with. Are you listening to me?
Perfect. Mister?
Yeah. I promised we'd get there. I promised we'd get there. I couldn't keep my promise. I'm so sorry.
Is this where I get my power armor?
Up here. Boss! We got somebody up here!
Why don't you get down here?
You got the touch!
Take it easy, Mama. You okay?
I'm fine, Preston. Quit fussing.
That was a pretty amazing display. I'm just glad you're on our side.
You guys gonna be okay now?
Yeah. For a while, anyway. We can at least move some... Listen. When we first met, you asked about the Minutemen. One thing you should know about us, we help out our friends. So here, for everything you've done, thank you.
What happens now?
For the longest time, Mama Murphy's had a vision of a place called Sanctuary. Some old neighborhood, but one we can make new again.
Why don't you come with us? I could really use your help.
What would I need to do?
You'd need to stay strong like you've been. 'Cause there's more to your destiny. I've seen it. And I know your pain.
My destiny? What do you mean?
You're a man out of time. Out of hope. But all's not lost. I can feel your son's energy. He's alive.
Where is my son? Where is Sean?
Oh, I wish I knew, kid. I really do. But it's not like I can see your son. I can just feel his life force, his energy. He's out there. And even I don't need the sight to tell you where you should start looking. The great green jewel of the Commonwealth. Diamond City. The biggest settlement around.
What's in Diamond City? Is Sean there?
Look, kid, I'm tired now. Maybe you'll bring me some chems later. The site will paint a clearer picture.
No. Mama Murphy, we talked about this. That junk. It's gonna kill you.
Oh, shush, Preston. We're all gonna die eventually. We're gonna need the site. And our new friend here, he's gonna need it too. Now let's get going. Sanctuary awaits.
All right, folks. Thanks to our friend here, it's safe to move out. We're heading for that place Mama Murphy knows about. Sanctuary. It's not far.
She knows about it? You mean she had one of her visions while she was stoned out of her gourd? And now you want us to just head out on another wild goose chase based on no better plan than Mama Murphy saw it?
It can hardly turn out any worse than...
Everybody just take it easy. We're all in this together, right? So Marcy, you got a better idea of what we should do next? Anybody? Well then, sanctuary it is. Let's just hope it lives up to its name.
Come on, June, it's time to go.
Oh, okay.
Hey.
Yes? Well, look at you. How'd a girl like me ever get so lucky, huh?
Why are you telling me all of this?
Because we're partners, through thick and thin. I can't imagine trying to do this without you.
What do you mean by that?
You're doing the right thing. Helping others when they need it. The whole world is broken. The world before was nothing but petty governments going to war, dragging us into it, and shooting whoever refused to clean up the mess. We thought we were safe, but we were just kidding ourselves. Everyone knew the world was going to end at some point, and then it did. I only wish we could have all gotten out, as a family. Hell, I didn't expect to wake up 200 years in the future.
I feel the same way.
Hey, hun, how are you feeling?
I want to help people, but life can be harsh. It's hard enough just dealing with the present.
I appreciate you telling me all of this. I know it's difficult. Hey, I'm proud of you. Sure, the world may have ended, but you won't have to stand alone anymore. I'm here for you.
Wow. Your hair looks great.
That's my handsome guy. Honey, don't forget. I'm always happy to talk with you. I always will. Hun, can we chat?
Why? What's up?
Don't worry. I'm not gonna hurt you. You know, and I know, that between the two of us, there's nothing that can stand in our way to make this a better world. So, I was wondering if we could get to know each other better. But it depends. Do you more than like me?
My beautiful wife, you do know you've got the most beautiful eyes I've ever seen.
Your eyes. That's the reason I said yes when you asked me out. You have such strong cheekbones.
Sweetie, you look as beautiful as the day we met.
Did I mention how much I love that new haircut?
Yes.
Even after all we've done, you've certainly made a difference to me. And the destination's not worth it if you're not a part of the journey. Because I don't think I'd be happier with anyone else. You still love me, though, right?
Of course I do. I'm in love with you. And I don't think I'd be happier with anyone else.
My marriage was the most important thing in my life. You've shown me how to be a better person.
What you said to me before, coming from you, it means a lot. I realize now that I'm in love with you too. Thank you. Let's get out of here.